ID Quantic, we're based in Geneva, Switzerland, and we were founded in 2001 as a spin-off of the University of Geneva. And we're one of the first generation quantum companies. We've brought out a quantum random number generator in 2005. We commercialized the first quantum key distribution in 2005, which has been used to protect data in the Geneva state elections since 2007. So it's now been in use for the last 8 years. We've got a next generation quantum key distribution system, which is the first blade mounted device. So it's scalable. It can be slot into ETSI and ATCA network devices to provide keys for network equipment. And that would be the first trusted node device, which would allow you to do hop-to-hop QKD, quantum key distribution, on a longer scale, so where distance is no longer a limitation. And we've got customers who are in governments. The governments, it's still semi-testing. A lot of them are still trying out to see how they would implement this, how it would be used on real networks. But we've got real customers in the banking area who are using it to protect data between data centers. So, you know, hundreds of gigs of data between data centers and in their metro area networks. So that's something where it's already been in use since early 2007 in real environments. Well, I think we're going to look back at 2015 at the year where quantum technologies really started to be taken seriously. And in the world of quantum key distribution, there are two notable events. One is ETSI published a white paper on the need to have to adopt quantum safe security. That was actually published end of 2014, December 2014. But in the ETSI white paper, it stated for the first time that companies, industries, governments needed to start taking the threat of quantum computers seriously and needed to start thinking now about how to move to a quantum safe infrastructure. And the threat obviously is that data is downloaded now and broken once a quantum computer is available. And that would impact a lot of banks, any company or industry or government which has data with long-term security requirements, whether it's your DNA or biometric data, medical, government, state secrets, which have sometimes a 50-year lifetime, all of those need to be protected in a quantum safe way so that they're not broken when a quantum computer comes in the next 10 years. The second notable event was the announcement by the National Security Agency, the American NSA, to start moving towards quantum safe crypto methods. And that was rather an obscure web page on their crypto site, which said, do not move towards, we recommended you to move away from RSA, key exchange, public key crypto, to elliptic curve. What we're now telling you is do not adopt elliptic curve. Wait until we come up with a next proposal for quantum resistant algorithms and other quantum safe key exchange methodologies. And of course, quantum key distribution falls into that category. And that was in August 2015. So we're going to see this as the year when companies, governments started to take the need for quantum safe security seriously. I think we see three separate initiatives. One is governments are funding academic research more than ever. The UK Quantum Hubs program, for example, is a leading example of that. Delft University in the Netherlands has been funded to the tune of 135 million euros. So there's really a lot of government initiatives in funding quantum technologies. The Chinese have 90 separate funding projects. We don't know the full dollar amount, but it's huge. Then you have industry starting to take a look at the development of quantum computers. Google is opening quantum labs, has opened quantum labs. Intel is investing in quantum computing engineering. Other companies are investing in QKD. You start to see industry efforts by network operators like SK Telecom in South Korea. KPN has publicly called to have quantum safe security in the next 5 years. So you really see an awareness among the end users. And then of course, you have more and more awareness among the end users. They're starting to be educated on the fact that they need to, that the world will change. This will be a quantum revolution in every sense, both on the big data side with all the possibilities that it brings and all the threats it brings to data protection that quantum key distribution needs to resolve.